I used to be super chismosa. Everyone's like this. Hi, how are you? So she knows when something's up that I had to put myself on some kind of a rehab. I actually have bad skin. Somebody asked me the other day, do you have fillers? Wait, wait lang. There's a problem here.
Hi, I'm Jessica with Jasmine, Camille, and Gia, and you're watching Gtalk.
She is a singer, songwriter, actress, dancer, model, TV host, and a musical theater performer.
She is the daughter of the divine diva Zsa Zsa Padilla and the granddaughter of famous boxing referee Carlos Padilla Jr.
She is dubbed as the OPM showbiz royalty of the Philippines.
And we are so excited to have the beautiful Karylle.
Woo!
Yay! Yay!
Hi!
Welcome. I'm so kilig to be on your show. Honestly, I don't know where everyone is. So would you mind telling me where you guys are? Are you all in America?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. We're all in the Bay Area, California.
Karylle, we want to get to know more of you through our Gtalk's 2-minute alphabet fast talk.
Ooh, okay.
So that's where we mention a word or phrases and you respond with the first thought that comes to mind.
All right, so that's 26 questions in 2 minutes. Are you ready?
Ready.
Let's go.
A, assumptions about you.
Girly.
B, most beautiful celebrity.
Gal.
Gal Gadot.
Yeah. Oh, I didn't know how to say it, so I said gal na lang.
Good. C, I can change the world by...
smiling.
D, a near-death experience.
Van rides.
E, most embarrassing moment.
Ah, volleyball.
F, my best features are?
Eyes. Oh, lips.
Thoughts on ghosting.
Do it.
H, your hairbrush song.
Ah, none. I don't brush my hair.
I can be very...
truthful.
J, what do you do when you get jealous?
Quiet.
What would you like to be known for?
Good deeds.
L, worst breakup line you have ever heard.
It's not you, it's me.
M, a celebrity you're mistaken for.
Anyone with a K. Karylle, Kyla, even Camille.
Childhood nickname you did not like.
Bachokekoy.
O, childhood obsession.
Pop rocks.
Worst pickup lines.
I wasn't a victim of pickup lines. A victim of feeling guys, maybe.
Q, one question you would ask if you ever see an alien.
What time do we go?
R, reveal something juicy about yourself.
Think of anything that I have not shared is what I'm thinking.
My mother used to scold me for being...
for chewing too loud.
P, my biggest transformation.
Oh, today, the hair. My hair's kulot.
Most unusual fan request.
To work in our karaoke. Okay.
V, Vice Ganda's number one advice to you.
Just to be true to your feelings, especially because of the pandemic, and that you can allow yourself to feel what you're feeling.
W, what do you usually worry about?
I'm trying ichigo ichi. I'm trying not to worry, but yes, COVID.
X, message to your exes.
This is something that people in the Philippines like to say, stay put ka lang dyan. It doesn't mean anything.
Toughest year of your life was when?
Maybe when I was a kid.
Z, best way to friend zone someone.
To heart their message.
Okay, you've made it to the end of the alphabet. That wasn't too bad, right?
Okay. Okay. Hirap mag-English.
No, you can speak Tagalog if you want.
I know, but just to mispronounce anything, it's so hard. The pressure.
No pressure at all. Yep,
great,
no pressure.
Great.
We actually wanted to go through some of your answers because you had some very interesting responses.
And then reveal something juicy about yourself.
Okay. Have you thought of anything? Juicy like chismis. I used to be super chismosa that there would be holy weeks that I would fast on gossip. So maybe that's juicy in the sense that I like to gossip that I had to put myself on some kind of a rehab.
Oh my god. What do you mean by chismosa?
Like chismosa, there used to be these really detrimental, what do you call those? Blind items, and I would be so obsessed with them that I would actually go on the website a minute before they would post the next item. Because you know how it used to be like vlogs, and they would post it, let's say, 12 midnight. So at 11:59, I'd be there waiting for the gossip. And you know how celebrities are so angry na, you shouldn't be chismosa, etc. In respect private lives, I was there. I was there for it.
What was the obsession?
Yeah, I don't know why I was so obsessed, because they would give little clues and everything. And it got so bad that my husband, Yael, would also know all the juicy chismis for the week. And I realized it was so bad when he was the star of this one party where all the aunties were talking about the latest gossip. And he's like, yeah, I know that one. I think it's so and so. And I was looking and I just saw how bad it got that Yael would even have to take interest in it just because I was into gossip. So I was like, wait lang. There's a problem here. This is not a good hobby, especially when your husband is already taking on your bad hobby.
But don't you agree? I think men are more chismoso.
I do. No, because they pass it off as facts, I think.
Oh my God.
I know. It's not like I think. It's like I know. I heard from, and it's always as news or facts.
Was he also part of the retreat?
No. He just dropped it because he didn't really care for it so much. It was more like to bond with me.
Did he somehow like help you in doing some research, investigating?
No. The clues were just too obvious, so you already know. And everyone gives away the clues in the comment section anyway. But yes, I'm cured.
So I wanted to ask you, because you seriously, you look like you're my age or younger. Please tell me your beauty regimen, because I am obsessed.
Oh, thank you. Well, I actually have bad skin. So because I had breakouts when I was younger, I had to really work on my skin. So the green juicing, all these things. Another thing is, of course, I go to Bello. So Dr. Bello fixed my very, very bad breakout from when I first started acting. So I have oily skin, which is a blessing because I don't need to use all the creams. Also, I'm not allowed to use a lot of the creams because my face will break out. So I do regular cleaning appointments in Bello. So I alternate the fruity facial, but it's a botanical something something. And then sometimes they do a glyco peel when my skin's not doing so well. So there, because I do put on makeup every day, I have to do the cleanings twice a month. And then on top of that, I do RevLight, which is something I did 2 days ago. So it's pretty fresh. RevLight is not the most high-tech one, but it gets rid of facial hair. Oh, so I'm a very Balbon girl. So I don't know if you can see my arms. I'm Balbon. I used to go as far as bleaching it. But then when you're older, you find out, you know, all these things are not good for your skin if you bleach your actual arm, right? So I stopped doing that and I just kind of accepted it. But the ones for the little fine facial hair, especially here, RevLight does remove that. And then there's another machine I alternate it with every other month. It's called Angel White. So that's it. That's pretty much what I do. No Botox yet. I'm very blessed to have high cheekbones. Like somebody asked me the other day, do you have fillers? I'm like, no. They're just pretty high. At a certain point, like when I do eat a lot, it's just too round. But I'm like, no, I'm going to accept my face.
Yeah, so that's your mom, right?
Huh?
The high cheekbones.
The high cheekbones, is it? Mom? Well, definitely the padilla pout. But it's all natural.
I see it. Yeah.
I found out that all my relatives from America, even my cousins, every time anyone sees a mirror or is in front of a phone, everyone just does this. So when we do our FaceTime, everyone's like this. Hi, how are you?
It's great.
It's noisy, but it's big fun. It's super funny. If you need specific things I use, I do use the Obagi cleanser. There is an acne drying cream that I sometimes use and a laser cream if I have a breakout. But pretty much that's it. I'm not allowed to really use creams. I need a good eye cream, but I just use whatever for now.
Well, when you were going through your breakouts as a kid, did you do anything different with like your diet or like drinking more water sort of thing?
Well, when I was a kid or when I was a teenager and I had those really bad breakouts, they had all those products in America, the ones you can buy in a box. Mm-hmm. It was color green. I know you know what I'm talking about. And I'm sure
Proactive?
Yes. Oh, I tried that. Because, syempre, we have relatives from the States and we're like, oh, no, case breaking out. So I tried everything. The Roaccutane, was it? And I think that was the one that was a really, really strong antibiotic. And I don't think it really worked. And then finally, a relative of ours, Tita Ali, who works for Belo, she suggested just bring her to Belo because they opened their first clinic in Green Hills at the time and it specialized on skin. So that's when I started really becoming a Belo baby. Another thing that I really realized later on was when I would go to the spa, which I endorse, it's called Blue Water Day Spa. I would see a lot of Koreans, and Koreans have great skin. And I would see that they would always do sauna and massages. And when I saw that, I was like, ah, there must be something here. What's the secret? And I did look into it, and they do a lot of it to remove the toxins and I guess to relax yourself. So the massages are a big part of our home routine. So yeah, Elle and I give each other just even simple massages on the hands or the feet. But it's always a race to who has to do it. Because whoever does it doesn't fall asleep immediately. So whoever asks for the massage first is the winner.
I want to ask you for most beautiful celebrity local.
Like without makeup, I have to say my mom. Because when you see her without the makeup, but of course that's my super biased opinion. But aside from her without makeup, it's really Anne. With makeup or without, right? This is Finny Finn Finn. So she knows when something's up and she just wants to be part. And every time she shows up on an interview, Finny Finn lovers, the account will somehow screen cap it immediately and post it, right?
Oh, it's
so cute.
our little celebrity Finny Finn Finn. So yeah, Anne is so pretty. Like sometimes I would just look at her skin. If ever she's late for showtime, you'll see that she has not even like an ounce of foundation. It's like, you're so lucky, your skin is so good. I always tell her, and she'll just put like little bits of makeup. That's why I love her makeup, because BLK is really made for people like me who don't know how to do the makeup. She tried to uncomplicate the process, which is their tagline. So yeah, I think she's also like somebody with a huge smile, kind of like Julia Roberts, how when she smiles, it's just the biggest smile. And because of the actual just size of it, right? It's like, it makes you want to just reflect the feeling. So yeah, I think it'd have to be Anne.
Did I hear you correctly when you said that the childhood nickname they called you was Butchakoy?
Yeah, well, my mom had a really cute name for me. It was after my favorite bubblegum. I don't know if you guys were able to ever try Bazooka. Mm-hmm. Bazooka bubblegum, yeah, with a comic strip. So there's this little store in Green Hills. I don't know if you guys go to Green Hills because that was where we lived when I was a kid. It had all sorts of candy. It's called Regina's in Shopsville. And one of my favorite things was bazooka. And when you're a kid, you just, you know, buy the pop rocks or the bazooka. So my mom always called me Baji Waji Bazooka bazooka Bubblegum. But that translated to Bachokekoy. I don't know how. But of course, the nicer one was the long one, right? Like the Baji Waji Baj, which is Baj, actually.
Maybe you were trying to say it, but you couldn't pronounce it.
No, I think it was my second mom, who's my yaya. I think she was the one who called it Bachokekoy, but she says it fondly. So I don't mind it that much anymore.
As you said, the toughest year of your life was when you mentioned childhood. Why was that tough?
Well, my parents separated when I was around 6. So of course that was not easy. So yeah, since then I've done a lot of family healing, and I do talk about it a lot because I don't think a lot of people are aware that there is such a thing as healing of the family tree or just dealing with your childhood issues. So mm-hmm. I think that's pretty much why I talk about it openly, and because everything is all good now. It took a while, but yeah, that was pretty tough.
You raise funds for kids with cancer every single year.
So there is this group that I've been helping for years. It's called Child House. So they're pediatric cancer patients. Child House is a halfway house for children with cancer. But then, of course, they couldn't turn their backs on kids with other ailments. So what happens in the Philippines is that a lot of people are from the province, and the big hospitals are in Manila. So for you to be able to go all the way to Manila, find a house to live in, it's a bit of a stretch for your budget. So Han C, one of the owners of SM, he actually purchased a home because Child House went through a lot of troubles a couple of years ago. They were kicked out of their original home. So here comes Mr. C to the rescue and his beautiful wife, Karyl. And they've been such big supporters of Child House ever since. So there are two branches. One is in Quezon City and one is in Manila, because that's where the big hospitals are. I think it's loosely based on the Ronald McDonald House. Mm-hmm. You know how they have those little places near the hospitals, especially for pediatric cancer patients. They're not really in, what do you call that, when it's inpatient? Mm-hmm. They're not really inpatient. Mm-hmm. So they spend a lot of time in Manila, and there's a lot of time in between the treatment. So it has to be a happy space for them to live in while they're doing their chemo.
It's so amazing because you actually buy whatever they want for Christmas.
It's a cute way to involve friends. I've always believed that if you give people the opportunity to help, it's easier, and they don't think that there is stealing in the process. You know, we have a lot of corruption in the country and mistrust. So we want to make sure to involve people, let them do a little shopping. So we ask the kids for their wishes, and we've been able to do it for more than 15 years now. I guess the system works wherein, you know, the kids wish, and then when you see their wishes are so simple, it kind of like the last one, it really broke my heart just to see that they asked me for this lotion. And you know how many lotions we have in our toilets, and then that's their Christmas wish.
Right.
Like a Cetaphil lotion, because it's probably hypoallergenic, right? Or a can of milk.
Yeah.
That's just as simple as that. But that's their main wish for Christmas. So
yeah,
I guess it puts things into perspective as well.
Thank you so much, Karylle, for playing our game. And, you know, maybe now our viewers will get to know another side of you.
Yes.
So do you have anything to promote?
Please do check out my Facebook. It's We Love Karylle on Facebook. It was a gift from my fans, so please don't judge me for the name. I'm not trying to psych you into thinking, you know, you should love me. But yeah, We Love Karylle. I'd also like to promote, of course, my mom's show, which is on YouTube. That's Jasha Padilla on YouTube. It's also Buhay Probinsya. That's the show on TFC. So I'm guessing everyone's on TFC. Yael and I have been working on BNB. That's the series of Sangre Productions. So I would love to invite you all to check out the soundtrack of the show.
Well, again,
and of course, Showtime every day. Yeah. If you guys watch TV, TFC. I'd like to say hi to all my family and Yael's family, all everyone in America. So I hope to see you guys later this year when we go to Napa Valley. we're literally planning all these little vacations and little trips. But okay. Yeah, someday. Or maybe we could do some. Oh my God, I have a YouTube channel. Please do check it out. I forget. It's called Karylle Mundo. So yeah, maybe we could do something together there. Us girls.
Yes, thank you so much, Karylle. And we leave you with this quote. Success isn't just about what you accomplish in your life. It's about what you inspire others to do. Thanks for watching.